Hi! Today, let's learn how to create this beautiful animation in PowerPoint using Morph Transition. Take a look at this beauty. The numbers are changing so nicely and it looks professional. The thing is, you can do this effect even using motion path animation in PowerPoint. But then, for that you need to have the patience of this monk. Since I don't have that level of patience, I'm going to stick to Morph Animation. By the way, Morph Animation is only available for Microsoft 365 subscription or PowerPoint 2019 version or 2021 version. Now, with that out of the way, where can you use this beautiful animation effect in PowerPoint? I can think of some situations. First, if you want to make a pitch presentation to investors, then you can use this animation to tell your company history. They will immediately shower you with as much money as you want. Okay, they will at least listen to your presentation. Second, if you're a teacher and you're tired of seeing your students sleeping during your history classes, then you can use this animation to jolt them into attention. Okay, enough goofing around. Let's learn how to create this stunning animation from scratch. I'll take the example of French Revolution to demonstrate this effect. But before that, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com, the creator of Ramgopal's PowerPoint Mastery Program, a comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training program for professionals. Here I am on a new slide. There are a few things you need to set up before we can make that effect happen. The first one is you need to have numbers from 1 to 31 to indicate the date. So let us go here, pick up the text box tool and use 01 like this, hit and say 02 like this and 03 like this and so on. Again, for this you need to have the patience of our famous monk. A much smarter way is to go to Excel and then write your number 1 here and then click and drag from the corner of the cell all the way till 31. And then you have this option here called autofill options. You click on that and you say fill series. Now you have 1 to 31 available for you to just copy and paste on your slides. Let me right click, copy, go back to PowerPoint, right click and then paste using just keep text only option. Then you click on the bounding box and then choose a much thicker font. My favorite font, if you've been following around, is 2cm MT condensed extra bold. Let us increase the font size all the way till 96. Now that looks beautiful. Let us right align this and then reduce the width of this text box. Beautiful. So let us pick and keep it over here. The next step is to write our months. Once again, go to Excel and then say Jan. Once again, click and drag from the corner of the cell all the way till December. Right click, copy, go back to PowerPoint and then right click and paste it as text only. Select the previous text and then go to Home tab and choose this option here called Format Painter and then click and drag across this text. Now you have the same kind of formatting done for our months as well. And for this one, let us use left alignment. Now I can place this very close to the previous number. And once again, as I mentioned earlier, you need to adjust the width so that it matches the width of the text box. The next thing we need to do is to write our year. Since everything happened by the end of the 18th century, we are going to use just the number 17 here. Once again, select the formatting of our previous text, go to Format Painter and then apply the formatting to our number 17. Next, we need to have the years, which is 89 to 92. So let us select this number, press Ctrl D to create duplicate and place it right next to the previous one and say 89, hit enter, 90, hit enter, 91, enter, 92. So this is as much as we require. Now we have got all our text in place. The next step is to decide on where exactly we are going to place this date. For that, let me go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up the line tool and then draw a straight line like this. You don't really have to bother about giving it a different color and all that stuff. This is just for the placeholder so that the bottoms of these numbers can plonk in the right place. The last step is to paste your text here, which explains what happened on that particular date. So now we have all the ingredients in place. Let us cook the curry. The first date is 14th July 1789. So I'm going to choose the first one and then use my up arrow key so that I'm able to move these numbers in straight line. And that is very important. And now I have the number. which is plonked right on the line. Beautiful. Then let us have the month, which is July. Let us move this up. Neat. Then let us place the number 17 here. Then the year is 89. Excellent. Now this can be placed somewhere in the middle. Now in this tutorial, I'm not going to focus too much on the other elements like where do you need to place your text, whether you need to use photos to illustrate your points and all. That is completely up to you. The main purpose of this tutorial is to show you how to create this beautiful date scrolling effect. Now that we've got our first slide in place, let us duplicate this by using right click and duplicate slide option. The next important date is 27th August 1789. So you know what the routine is. You select the numbers and go all the way till 27. So this is done by using our up arrow key, as I mentioned earlier, so that we are able to retain the alignment. And then let us adjust the month here, which is August, and it is the same year, 1789. The event here is the declaration of the rights of man and of the citizen. So that is what is written here. Now let us right click and duplicate this again, and we are going to change the date. The date is 6th October 1789, and during this time there was a women's march in Versailles. Of course, you can continue to do that for the remaining events as well. I'm going to stop with just 3 so you can understand the process. The next step is to apply morph transition. So let us apply morph transition from the second slide onwards. So let us go to transitions and say morph transition. And the duration of 2 seconds is just fine. Now, when I go to the first slide and go to slideshow, this is how the effect looks. On a click, you can see that the dates are changing and our information is changing. Again, on another click, we have the next important event shown and the details are changing. The only issue here is we have all this additional text that is messing up the whole scene. So we are going to create a peeping hole through which we are going to see just this number, and everything else is going to be made obscure. So let us hit escape button, go to the first slide, and then create a nice peeping hole. Let us go to home, go to auto shapes gallery and pick up a rectangle tool, and then draw a box that is as nicely big as this. Once again, go to auto shapes gallery, pick up a rectangle tool, and then draw a rectangle that covers the entire slide end to end like this. Let us right click and send this rectangle back. So we have got this one selected. Then hold the shift button down and click on the earlier box, and then go to shape subtract. You can find that in shape format. Go to merge shapes and you can find shape subtract. Then select this shape, go to shape fill and give it white color. Go to shape outline and say no outline, and then select this and the text, right click, and then bring that to front. Now you have this beautiful mask that covers all the unnecessary portions, and now we have just the date and the associated explanation shown. We don't really need this line, so I'm going to delete this. Select this, press Ctrl C, copy, go to the second slide, press Ctrl V, and then click and drag for the explanation, right click and bring that to front. Do the same thing for the third one as well. Press Ctrl V, then select the text, right click and bring that to front. Of course, you can always adjust the positioning of these text elements. It is completely up to you. I'm not going to focus too much on those niceties. Now, the last step is we don't really need these lines from the second and third slides. So we go to the first slide, go to slideshow, and this is how your slide would look. You will show the date and then give your explanation saying that on 14 July 1789, the siege and the surrender of the Bastille happened. Then on a click, the dates change in a very beautiful style. And then you provide the explanation for the next significant date. And then click again and the dates change and you provide your explanation. Yeah, by the way, I forgot to ask you, did you sign up for our 25 Creative PowerPoint Ideas free email course? Anyway, you click on the link in the description box below and sign up for the course. If not, you can always find the link right here on the right hand side. Click and sign up. These PowerPoint ideas I don't share anywhere else, and they can definitely make your slides look better.